It's really a pleasure and honor to be here today. During the spirited discussions that Jan alluded to earlier, I just want to point out that the young prize winners agreed that if they went over time, it would come away from the more mature prize winners' time, because we are less known entities. I would like to thank the Vilcek Foundation for giving me this great honor, which I share with my students and postdocs. I also want to thank my wife and my children for their love, my parents and former advisors for their guidance, and my three sisters and in-laws for their support. I also want to acknowledge my institution, the University of Michigan, for providing a wonderful place in which to work. And finally, I would also like to thank my guests for being with us tonight on this wonderful occasion. I'd like to share with you my journey from Lebanon to the United States. I was born in Beirut to an Iraqi father and a Palestinian mother. A year later, civil war erupted in Lebanon, and for 15 years, my family lived in Greece, Italy, and Jordan, waiting for the war to end. While we were living in Jordan, Saddam invaded Kuwait, and as an Iraqi citizen, I was called to military service, and I was only 16 at the time. Luckily, before the invasion, I had applied to a boarding school for no really good reason. I'd applied to a boarding school in Wales and gotten accepted, and as it turned out, traveling abroad was one way of avoiding Saddam's military service. Even he believed in education. So at age 16, I headed to Llantwit Major in southern Wales, where I attended high school and watched the Gulf War on TV. After finishing my undergraduate degree in chemistry in Imperial College in London, I wanted to continue on and go to grad school, but as a foreign national, there were really limited funding opportunities in the UK. And so I decided to apply to the grad schools in the US, where admission came automatically with a tuition waiver and stipend for both US and foreign students alike. A few days after arriving at Yale University, I met my beautiful wife, Allison, who greatly distracted me from all of my studies. Fortunately, Allie had some good competition in my PhD advisor, Jim Prestigard, not because of his good looks, but because he made me fall in love with nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. I became passionate about seeing how the molecules of life jiggle and wiggle, and as a postdoc not too far from here at the Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center, Dinsha Patel gave me all the freedom in the world to test my own ideas, fail before it really mattered, and to develop my own way of doing science. Today, as a professor at U of M, I am one on the other side of the fence, and I have a lab filled with students that come from across the globe. I can see firsthand how bringing together talented people from vastly different cultures helps tear down cultural barriers and leads to the kind of creativity that knows no boundary. This creativity makes U.S. science special, and we should always strive to protect it. Thank you very much.